In this video, we'll delve into a new treatment option for severe asthma, tezepelumab, exploring its unique mechanism of action and the clinical trials that paved the way for its approval. Let us take a step back to understand this disorder. Imagine your airways as delicate tubes that deliver air to your lungs. In asthma, these airways become inflamed and overly sensitive. This means they react strongly to various triggers, like allergens, irritants, infections, or even temperature change. When triggered, the epithelial cells lining your airways release a protein called thymic stromal lymphopoietin, or TSLP. Think of TSLP as a conductor in an orchestra. It leads to a chain reaction, activating immune cells in multiple downstream pathways that can drive airway inflammation and contribute to airway hyperresponsiveness. The inflammation makes the airways even more sensitive, leading to further narrowing, mucus production, and consequently the hallmark symptoms of asthma: wheezing, coughing, shortness of breath, and chest tightness. Tezepelumab is a man-made monoclonal antibody, a precisely engineered molecule that targets TSLP specifically. Like a perfectly fitting puzzle piece, tezepelumab binds to TSLP, preventing it from attaching to the immune cells it would normally activate. This disrupts the inflammatory chain reaction, reduces airway inflammation and hyperactivity, and helps control asthma symptoms and lessen the frequency of attacks. Tezepelumab, under the brand name Tezspire, was first approved in December 2021 as an add-on maintenance treatment for patients over 12 years with severe asthma. It is now available as prefilled syringe or pen, to be administered subcutaneously once every 4 weeks. A large clinical trial called Navigator tested the effectiveness of tezepelumab in controlling asthma. Over 1,000 patients aged 12 and over were involved. Half the group received a tezepelumab injection subcutaneously every 4 weeks, while the other half received a placebo alongside their usual asthma medication. The study looked at how often asthma exacerbation, or flare-ups, occurred over a year. The results were very positive. The annualized rate of asthma exacerbations was 0.93 with tezepelumab and 2.10 with placebo. This means that people who received tezepelumab had 56% fewer asthma attacks compared to those on placebo. Additionally, tezepelumab significantly reduced the number of asthma attacks requiring a trip to the emergency room or hospitalization. Similar findings were observed in the 52-week pathway trial, which enrolled 550 adult patients with severe asthma. Just like in the Navigator trial, participants were either given tezepelumab or a placebo alongside their regular asthma medication. Similar to the larger trial, the results showed that tezepelumab significantly reduced the number of asthma attacks patients experienced throughout a year compared to those on placebo. Tezepelumab's unique mechanism and promising clinical results offer hope for a future with less severe asthma. While tezepelumab is a major step forward, it's important to remember that it's not a replacement for existing asthma medications. It's a targeted therapy for those with severe asthma who need additional options. And that's it for today's pharmacology video. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel for more pharmacology content.